Hey everyone, Ideogram just came out with their newest version, Ideogram 2A. It's supposed to be faster, cheaper, and have better text, just giving you that premium designs that you're looking for print on demand. I thought it'd be cool to test out Ideogram 2A versus 2, since I just did this video right here about best AIs on the market and for print on demand. So I'm gonna take the ones that I did there on Ideogram, which was in the version before 2, and I'm gonna test it against 2A, see how much better it is. Also in this video, I'm gonna test out the batches to see if that comes out in 2A and how much better those are as well, just to see how it does it a lot faster. We're gonna try and do it in real time, see how fast it actually is. So let's take a look and go into Ideogram right now. All right, so here we are on Ideogram. Everything looks exactly the same, but where you'll see the difference is when you come in here and you do this. So now we have the option between 1, 2A, and 2. So 2 has a lot more features, but 2A is a lot faster and cheaper. So you'll see right here, uses 1.5 credits as opposed to using 3 credits, so half the amount of credits. And it just has some other default features. So I'm gonna see if what's the difference here. I actually ran some through the 2A and I'll show you here in my creation. So forgive me for all the other stuff that's on here. So you may have noticed this. I ran Pizza is My Valentine. You'll see right here 2A. It's just nice and clean compared to the one that I did before. And we're gonna actually look at these side by side so you can see. The other one takes longer and, you know, it depends on which one you like better. I think this still turned out pretty good. This is also 2A on the one that we did before. Here's some other ones we can look in here. The graphics are really cool. I like this one as well. And then for the Meowty partner, I think this turned out great. That those cats always get me. There you go. That's really cool. So I'm gonna show you the ones in the video I did before. It's all the way down here. So forgive me for all of those St. Patrick's ones that I did. I'll show you what about that later. But so here, Meowty partner. So this is the ones that I did in 2. You can see 2 here. And it's good. I mean, it's nice, but we're gonna compare this pizza one, that Meowty one, and then this shenanigans one from 2 to 2A, see if there's any improvements, or is it just faster and saves you some credit. So even if it's the same, it will save you some credits too. So I'll put all of these onto a thing, a slide, and then we'll look at them together because it's kind of hard to kind of scroll it back and forth. All right, very quickly, I took the two and the 2A, and let's put it together. You can see it side by side, so I think that would be really relevant. For those of you that don't know, I didn't watch my video that I did with this, here is the prompt that I use for the pizza. And I used this through that whole video, and I used it for both of these as well, and then I'll show you the prompts for the other ones. I'm gonna move my face out of here. So you don't have to see that here. There, I think that works. All right, so yeah, let's take a look at this. So 2, which I just did like a week ago, and here's 2A, which I just did recently. I actually like 2A, and I'll tell you why. It's a lot easier to read. You see the contrast with the pizza. I don't know if it did that intentionally. I didn't say use white, but it did it. And the pizza is a lot clearer. Like this one right here that I used, I think in my video, it kind of looked like a pizza. And so it kind of lowered it for me. But here they all really look like they got it. It's more cartoony and a lot simpler drawing, but I think people know when they see it on the t-shirt that that's an actual pizza. So, and it's using the hearts inside of here, which is really smart. So. Yeah, that's my personal preference. I think the number 2 still would work, but this one just looks a lot cleaner on the red and so on. So different kind of red actually too, which is interesting. It kind of changed the colors on the red and the text. But the text just looks a lot easier to read. Maybe not as fun as this one up here, but definitely easy to read. And all of them, I believe, are spelled correctly. So that's one strong point with ideogram is the text comes in great. And so this is going to be really easy to remove the background because how clean it is and the contrast on it. All right, let's go to the next one. So here's the ideogram 2 versus 2A. Actually, my face should be here since I have the title here. I don't know. Let's just move it around. So the prompt for this one, here it is for the Meowty, which I used in that other video. And then this is Meowty partner. So 2 versus 2A. Now, this one's a little tougher. And I think I really like this one, which is by number 2. But 2A is still not bad for faster and cheaper. I think it still did really well. But I'm gonna give 2 on this one, and that's just for this type of style. I think maybe the more detailed style, you may wanna have it take a little longer and not as fast. You can see the reason I like this is because of all the details. And I think if you're gonna do something more detailed, then maybe 2 because it takes a little longer and gonna do it. But if you need something quick and the design or the style doesn't matter so much, I think this one, it does text great, does simple illustrations pretty well. I mean, this is still pretty good, but the expression on the face and everything on 2, I think does a lot better. All right, last one here. Ideogram 2 versus 2A for the shenanigans with my homies, gnomies. Here's the prompt that I used if you haven't seen it. And yeah, let's take a look side by side. This one's a little closer. I'm gonna give it to 2A though this time. So this time I don't need my gnomes in this case on a t-shirt to be very detailed. Like this one is very detailed, which is cool. But I think for a t-shirt design for St. Patrick's Day, I think this one would do well on 2A. So would this one. So I think, you know, for me, 2A is winning it just by a little bit. I think that the gnomes on this one are better in my opinion than this one. I don't need all the detail like this one does here. Although the details can help you stand out a little bit, I think in this case, I guess it's a case by case basis. You're gonna have to do this. This is kind of a cool thing that it did. Shenanigans with my gnomies with the clover here. So you may, I like that it kind of brainstorms and thinks out of the box, whereas this one kind of just gives you the quick stuff, which can work as well. So let me know what you think in the comments. Let's get back to ideogram and I'll show you something else. Okay, back on ideogram here. One of the things that I've been using a lot this year is their batches. So you can see here I've made 3 pages already of these batches, and I'm gonna do another one. I did a St. Patrick's Day one that you saw when I was scrolling through. And I'm wondering if I do a batches now that there's 2A, will it do batch generation in 2A and will it be faster? I'm not sure. I haven't done it yet. So you can see this one was done February 3rd before the upgrade. So I'm gonna try it out. And the way I'm gonna try it out is with a CSV file. You can download the template here. And then you may be wondering, well, what text am I gonna use? This is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go to ChatGPT 4.0. I just asked, give me 10 short St. Patrick's Day phrases, and it gave me this, and I made this CSV file. Check it out. Here it is. Simple CSV file. Visibility private, so only I can see it. Aspect ratio 4:5. Magic prompt auto. And all I did was vintage style the St. Patrick's Day t-shirt design with a solid black background and a St. Patrick's Day graphics. And St. Patrick's Day graphics with the text, and then in that text I added these. So you can see it's the same lucky and lit, shamrock rollin', and kiss me, I'm Irish, and that. And save this as a CSV file, which it is, new St. Patrick's Day sayings. And then I'm gonna go back to here and upload this spreadsheet. Now we're gonna do this in real time, so let's see how fast this thing is. So first, it's gonna give me 40 images like that. Well, I hope like that. And it's gonna be a number of because I had 10 lines for each, right? And we're gonna see private. This is what I put in here. And then it's using the priority credits, 20 credits only. So makes me wonder if it's not the 2A. But I'm gonna start batch generation here. And we're gonna see how fast this is. It's doing it. It's in progress. Okay, so it's not like super fast right now. It's doing it. Maybe it's just doing it in the background. I wonder if I just refresh. Maybe it doesn't show it. Oh no, there it is. There's 30. Okay, 30%. And 80. Holy cow, that was a big jump. And let's see if we can get to 100%. And yeah, there you go. Done. Okay, so I can either download this or I can go to my creations. You can see there's a check mark right there. And let's see how it did, first of all. Not bad. I didn't say what graphics to put in. I just said St. Patrick's Day graphics. So we got a whole bunch of cool stuff here. And yeah, see that? Okay, the big test is what are these? Are these 2 or 2A? I like this one. And let's see. Oh, it does it in 2. So it doesn't do automatically do it in 2A, which I thought it may do, but I think it's because it's using the priority credits and it's gonna take a little more time since it's batches. It's not like the speedy thing that you want it to do. So that makes a lot of sense actually to me. But let's take a look how 2 did. Sinigang, I don't like that guy. That one's kind of scary. That one, not so great. Shenanigans loading. Now, if I knew what to put in the graphic, I think that could help. Like I could put a loading bar or something like that. I think that would have helped. Let's see what else we got here. Classy, sassy, classy, and a bit of sassy. That's kind of funny. I might take this out right here. Let's see. Oh, this one's really nice. Stay golden, lucky charm. I like that. Let's see what I got. But you can see I got 40 of them just that fast. Chasing rainbows and whiskey. Let me take out this guy. Yeah. One thing I wish that it did, I said black background and I wish it took this out. And maybe that's because of the vintage style that's in there. That could be it. See, feeling green and gold, very classic. So you can see I did got 40 designs in a matter of less than a minute. And yeah, hit and miss, but this one looks really cool. Lucky in that. So I can do it again and do it again and you know, play the odds and pick the ones that are really good, remove the background like I do in my videos, and this is great for a t-shirt right here. Or it's also great for brainstorming. So if you don't know what kind of things to do, you can have it kind of brainstorm for you and be like, oh, maybe this should have something else in there, and then redo it with the graphic that you want, or maybe just give you ideas on what could be done for something. So there you go, 40. I use that batch thing a lot this year. I'm trying to get just more and more designs out there and seeing if it sells. I'll let you know if I get a lot of hits on these for St. Patrick's Day. But yeah, now all I have to do is kind of upscale these, remove the background, and they're ready for t-shirts. So have fun with this one. This is Ideogram 2.0, and now you have the option to use 2.0 and 2A. So 2.0 is the batch. If you want, take a little more time, have the design do take longer. More details, I would imagine. And then 2A is now like the turbo, the fast one. Still gives you a great job, like you've seen, but if you don't need graphics that have so much detail and it still spells it correctly, still gives you some good results. So if you want to save some credits on this one as well, there you go. So there you go. That's Ideogram 2A from 2.0. Both of them are really great, but yeah, like you can see, 2A will save you some time as well as some credits. So and still comes out really good. So try it out. If you haven't tried Ideogram, I have a link in my description that can gift you 100 priority credits if you sign up. If that's what you want to do, try it. I think you can try it out for free though, and then when you're ready, use it. I think the batches can be a real time saver. You saw that I did that in real time and it did 40 of them just like that. So really cool. If you want to see more about those batches, I have this video right here and have a bunch of Ideogram stuff on my channel. Thanks again for watching. And as always, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.